Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTNHD and how to configure Chrome to be your default browser within Windows 10. Now, Google already provides you the XML association file to do this. All you need to do is create your group policy to do this. So what you do is you get inside your Active Directory, go within your group policy management, create a new policy. I already created one, so I'm going to right click on it. We're going to go to edit, and within there you're going to go to policies, administrative templates, Windows components, expand Windows components, and the one that you want to go inside is the file explorer, and you want to locate set a default association configuration file. So double click on that, enable it, and you're going to point the path to that new Chrome default XML file. Now again, Google does provide this for you, so it's really easy. Now I have a machine right here, which is already added to the domain controller, and it's pointing into this OU right here. So let's go inside the Active Directory, Chrome. I'm going to refresh it real quick. And this machine right here is this guy right here. So I'm going to right click, go into System, and there goes the name, the PC, and this machine is already receiving that group policy. If you want, you could actually do is right click on the start menu. Let's open up PowerShell. We're going to run an rsop.msc, hit enter. It's going to run a nice little report of what policies this particular machine is being pushed into. So once that loads up, you're just going to navigate to that same location. So let's go to administrative templates, Windows components, Fire Explorer. Again, that's the only one that we're hitting. So you're going to see that set a default association configuration file. Double click on it, and it's pointing to that file. Now, to confirm it, there's a couple of ways. You can go inside your Action Center, go to All Settings, go inside Apps, go inside Default Apps, and within Default Apps, go all the way to the bottom, and then you're going to see your web browser pointing to Google Chrome. Now, for this to work, make sure that you restart your machine. If you're doing a group update force, it's not going to work until you restart the machine and log in again as the user, and then your web browser should point to Chrome. Hopefully, you guys enjoy this tip, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.